Hi, and welcome to the Finbox Academy. In the previous lesson of this dividend investing course, we outlined that dividend yield is equal to the annual dividends per share paid by a company divided by the stock price per share. Investors love dividends because they provide a consistent stream of cash income from their investment portfolio. However, the dividend yield alone doesn't present the whole story. What if a company is financing the dividend with debt or by issuing new shares? On the other hand, instead of paying a cash dividend, a company may opt to reward shareholders by buying back shares or paying off debt, since that's generally more tax efficient. In this lesson, you will learn how to calculate shareholder yield by building up to it using its components: dividend yield, buyback yield, and debt paydown yield. The shareholder yield is a financial metric that gives investors a complete picture of how the company uses its cash flow to reward shareholders. Instead of focusing on dividends alone, the shareholder yield also considers the buyback yield and the debt paydown yield. Dividends are just one way in which companies can reward their shareholders, and many of them decide to use their cash flow differently because of legal or tax considerations. So, if you are looking for yield, this metric is an excellent alternative to the more popular dividend yield ratio. We believe that the more comprehensive formula to calculate shareholder yield is dividend yield plus buyback yield plus debt paydown yield. Some investors define the shareholder yield as buyback yield plus dividend yield. At Finbox, we call this yield the net payout yield. We prefer the first formula because it provides investors a better picture of a company's total yield. If a firm puts cash into shareholders' hands by taking on debt, it is merely replacing equity value in its capital structure with debt. Let's break down the individual components of the formula. The dividend yield is calculated by dividing the total gross dividend paid over the last 12 months by the company's market capitalization. If a company paid $10 billion in dividends and has a market capitalization of $200 billion, the dividend yield would be equal to 5%. The buyback yield is equal to net shares repurchased by a company over the trailing 12-month period divided by the company's market capitalization. If a company repurchased shares worth $10 billion and sold shares worth $5 billion and has a market capitalization of $200 billion, the buyback yield would be equal to 10 minus 5 divided by 200, or 2.5%. The debt paydown yield is equal to the net change in long-term debt over the trailing 12-month period divided by the company's market capitalization. If a company issued $50 billion in debt notes and has a market capitalization of $200 billion, the debt paydown yield would be equal to 25%. You don't need to do the calculation alone, and you don't have to use a shareholder yield calculator. You can use the Finbox Data Explorer to access shareholder yield data for 100,000 plus companies worldwide. The average shareholder yield varies greatly among different sectors, so it is very useful to compare a company to its sector while evaluating its shareholder yield. As of July 4th, 2020, the sectors with the highest shareholder yields are consumer staples and energy. Not surprisingly, the shareholder yield is negative for all the other sectors, since companies have slashed dividends, halted buybacks, and added debt to their balance sheets to survive the coronavirus crisis. You can have up-to-date stats and graphs like that directly in Excel or in Google Spreadsheets with the Finbox Excel add-in. To download it for free, go to finbox.com/integrations/Excel. After you download the Excel add-in, you can download the sector benchmark model using the link in the description below. As our trusted readers already know, we are data-driven investors here at Finbox, so let's check some data. By investing in a portfolio of stocks with the highest shareholder yield between January 1, 2000 and December 31, 2016, you would have obtained an average excess return of 5.63%, beating the market to a large extent. At the same time, if you had invested in the first quintile of stocks with the lowest shareholder yield, you would have underperformed the market. You can find the link to the backtest in the description below. You can find the stocks with the highest shareholder yield using the Finbox stock screener. It covers more than 100,000 stocks worldwide and supports more than 1,000 metrics. What's more, you can also create custom metrics after exporting the results to Excel. The best part? You can use it for free forever. Before you leave, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because in the following days, we'll publish new videos with a lot of stats like the one you saw in this one that will help you improve your investment performance. See you at the next lesson.